for being here today. What a glorious morning we have on this Christmas Eve day to come to the Lord's house and worship the one. We're going to celebrate and be the reborn king tomorrow. So thank you for being here. I see that we have lots of visitors today, and I got to make my way around and talk to a few of you, not all of you, but if I didn't get you before the service, hopefully I'll get to catch you after the service. We want you to make yourself right at home and just make yourself comfortable. And I don't know how comfortable I want you to be. I want you to be ready to worship today. We have a great God, a great King that we are here to worship. And I'm just overflowing with praise this morning. The crud has finally caught me, so if I start coughing when I'm preaching later, I apologize in advance. A little congested today, but I'm excited to be here, excited to share the word, excited to worship with the praise team, and excited to worship with you. So thank you so much for being here, and I pray that God blesses our service today. Let's go to the Lord in a word of prayer, and then we'll turn it over to the praise team as they lead us in worship. Heavenly Father, how good it is to be here today. And Lord, I'm just excited to enter this time of worship. Father, a special day, Christmas Eve. And Lord, I know we have lots of things to do and lots of activities to partake in and lots of family activities and things going on, Lord. But as always, we pray that this time, in these few minutes, Lord, that our focus would not be on the things that we have to do, but our focus would be on the God that we get to serve and the love that you have for us as displayed through your giving of your Son, Jesus Christ. You so loved us that you gave your Son, that if we would believe in him, we would not perish, but have everlasting life. Lord, I pray that each one in this place believes in Jesus, has trusted Jesus as their Savior. But if there be somebody here today who's not, Lord, I pray you would speak to their heart through your Holy Spirit. There's nobody here, there's no person here that could convince anybody. There's no person smart enough, wise enough, with eloquent enough speech to save anybody. Lord, but you can save. And so we give you all authority, as you do already have authority in this place. You move as you need to move. You speak to us today. In the name of Jesus, we humbly beg, and amen.
Amen. It is truly good to see everyone here today. I'm just so delighted. You know, there's three services that's just special. One of them is a Good Friday service, I guess four services. And there's the Easter service that's good. And then we always have the service at Christmas, and we do the candlelight, and that was just awesome. Where we come and have communion as a family. That's a special. The Christmas service is just always special. You know, and where everybody, there's a lot of excitement. The kids are thrilled to death. They know it's almost time. They've been looking at that present under that tree forever. And they finally get to open this thing. So, but it's just a good time to come together as a church, as a family. We are a family here at the church. And just remember that our Lord and Savior came down to this earth as a child. And so we're going to sing three or four songs to you. So I'm not going to do a lot of talking. We're just going to sing. We want you to listen. We want you to sing. There's none of them we've done that you haven't heard before. So we want you to sing with us and just have a great Christmas service this morning. Let's all stand for this verse. We're going to sing Joy to the World. some a few weeks ago, and we messed it up. So we're going to give you an opportunity to hear us mess it up again. So now we've been practicing hard. I said that that will mess it up, but I shouldn't have said that. But it's a great song. Go ahead.
One way or another. Thank you.
God, as always, appreciate you all leading us in worship each and every week. Children's Church is stepping out in the back right now, so if you'd like to go to Children's Church, you can meet Shanna in the back. We appreciate all of our Children's Church workers each and every week having activities planned and Bible lessons planned for our children. If you want to open your Bibles this morning, the book of Matthew, chapter 1, that's already been our theme verses for the series that we've been in. And we're going to start there again today. It's Christmas Eve, the day before the celebration of the birth of Jesus, the Son of God. It's been a fun, but I don't know about you, but it's been a busy few weeks of shopping and cooking and Christmas get-togethers. So much fun. And here we are, one day away from the big celebration of Jesus Christ coming and God sending His Son. Our focus on Sunday mornings for the last month has been the names of Jesus. And our theme verse comes from Matthew chapter 1 here, beginning in verse 21 through 23. And these three verses wonderfully sum up why it is that Christmas is such a reason to celebrate. These precious verses give us two names of Jesus with two very important meanings. So read these with me now, if you would. Look at Matthew chapter 1, verses 21 through 23. And she bringing forth a son, she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, the holy virgin shall be the child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. And if you've got nothing else from this series for the past month, I hope you understand the importance of these three verses. The angel instructed Joseph to call the child Jesus. And we looked earlier in this series that that name means God saves. And then we read that this fulfills a prophecy from Isaiah. And that the name Jesus is given, he says, he shall save his people from his sins. But the other name given to fulfill the prophecy is Emmanuel, God with us. So when we put these two names together, Emmanuel and Jesus, we get the reason for the season. God came to be with us so that he could save us through his son, Jesus Christ. He is Jesus, God saves, and he is Emmanuel, God with us. God came to be with us so that he could save us. That's why he came. He came to save you and me from our sins. And he is the reason we celebrate. Listen to this. He is the reason that we celebrate, but we are the reason that he came. He's the reason we celebrate, but we are the reason he came. And as we've looked at this powerful thought over the past few weeks, we've looked at some other names that Scripture gives to Jesus. We saw that Jesus is the life. Jesus himself said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no one gets to the Father through him. He came to give us eternal life. And it's only available through Jesus Christ. We read that he is the light. He leads us through the darkness of this world and into life. His word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. We looked at Jesus, the lavish gift. And we read, thanks be to God for this indescribable gift. And we know that the wages of our sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, his Son. We look at Jesus being the living Word. He is the Word that was in the beginning, and he was the Word that became flesh and dwelt among us. We look at Jesus last week as a picture of God's love. In this way, God demonstrated his love for us that he sent his Son to be the propitiation, the payment for our sins. And how did Jesus come and pay the price for our sins? Well, we also looked last week that Jesus is the Lamb of God. He is that payment for our sins. He died in our place on Calvary's cross. He shed his blood, and his body was broken so that we could be forgiven. And we celebrated that, as Anthony said, this past Wednesday night in our candlelight and our communion service. And it was a sweet time together. And today I want us to look at three more powerful names of Jesus to prepare our hearts for tomorrow, for Christmas Day. Won't you pray with me once again? Heavenly Father, thank you for the beautiful time of worship we've had. And we join in with the angel chorus to you singing, Hallelujah, Hallelujah, you are so good. And Father, I pray, Lord, as we begin to look into your word this morning, Would you get me out of the way? And my sinus headache and my sinus pressure in my head, Lord, that's distracting me this morning, if I'm honest. And would you get out of the way? Would your Holy, would you just allow your Holy Spirit to take over now? And Father, we desperately need a word from you today. Lord, my heart longs to hear from you. So speak to us, Lord. You speak to us. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. So there is an outline in your bulletin if you'd like to follow along with me this morning. And the first thing of Jesus we're going to look at as we begin today is this. Jesus, the Savior. Jesus, the Savior. Look over Luke chapter 2, verses 10 and 11, if you'd like to turn there with me. Luke chapter 2, verses 10 and 11. And I believe it's on the screen behind me also. And then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. For behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a what? A Savior, who is Christ the Lord." So he is Jesus, our Savior. God sent his angel to bring a message of good tidings. And good tidings just means good news. And great joy for all people. And the good news is this, Jesus Christ was born. The Savior has arrived, and he is Christ the Lord. Emmanuel is for certain. God is with us, and he is Jesus. God saves, for he came to save us from our sins. And who is us? Well, the verse we just read answers that question. If Jesus, if the angel told Joseph that Jesus is going to save us from our sins, save the people from our sins, who is his people? Who is us? Well, the message that the angel brought here is that there is a Savior and it's good news of great joy which shall be to all people. All people. The good news of Jesus is for all people. No matter what color, no matter what race, no matter how good or bad they may be, no matter how religious or not religious they might be, no matter how rich, no matter how poor, Jesus Christ is the Savior born for all people, praise his name. And there are no exclusions in his offer of salvation. Nobody has to be left out. Nobody has to be forgotten. The Savior came for all people. And while he was here, he proved that. As he spent much of his time with people that others looked down upon. He spent time with tax collectors. He spent a lot of time with sinners. And that religious crowd, we read in God's Word, mocked him for that in their arrogance. Jesus ate with people that no one else would eat with. He touched people that nobody else would touch as he healed the lepers. His power brought sight to the blind. His power brought healing to the sick. His power brought hearing to the deaf. His power brought a voice to the mute. And his power brought movement to the lame. But most importantly this morning, his power brought salvation to the sinner. And that is you and me. That is exactly what you and I are. We are sinners. And so he came for all people, especially sinners like you and me. And it's true that there are no exclusions to whom his power can save. There is one fact, though, and that is that each person must make up their own mind to receive his gift of salvation. Now listen, it's available to all people. It's available to anyone. But sadly, there are some who have not accepted that gift of salvation. And so I ask you, have you? Have you received the gift of salvation from the Savior that was born? Listen, unto you is born a Savior, Christ the Lord. Unto you, did you miss that in the verse there? Did you see that? Unto you has been born a Savior. That means Jesus came for you. And he knew that you would sin. He knew you would struggle with belief. He knew you would fail. He knew you'd have major issues in life. He knew your family would be dysfunctional at times. He knew everything there is to know about you, and he knew it, and he left the glory of heaven to come and be born in a manger for you. So, yes, the good news is a Savior has been born, and it gives us great joy this morning because he's come for us. He's come for all people to save us. He is Jesus, the Savior. And I just want to give him praise today for coming. might save us. Praise that holy name of Jesus Christ, the Savior. And secondly this morning, he is Jesus the Lord. Jesus the Lord. Flip over to Philippians with me, or you can look at the screen behind me. Philippians chapter 2. I believe I have in the bulletin there 9 through 10, but we're going to add verse 11 this morning. Philippians chapter 2, verses 9 through 11. Therefore, God has also highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of those in heaven and those on earth and of those under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Now verse 9 there says, therefore. That indicates that something important has already been said. If you were to go back and read Philippians chapter 2, those verses that lead up to verse 9 simply tell us what we just looked at. Jesus came to be our Savior. They read that he humbled himself even to the point of death on a cross. And because of that, therefore, verse 9 says, God has exalted him and given him the name that is above every name. Say that name with me this morning. Say Jesus. Jesus. Say it again. Jesus. Listen, the name of Jesus is the name that is above every name. Some use it flippantly, like it's nothing. Some use it to swear. Some speak the name of Jesus in jest. But there is nothing funny about the name of Jesus. For one day every knee is going to bow and every tongue is going to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. His name shall be called Emmanuel, God with us. His name shall be called Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sin. He is both Savior and Lord. He's the lamb that was slain, but he is the lion that reigns, for he is Lord. And God his Father has given him this name. And when you speak the name of Jesus, you speak authority. When we speak the name of Jesus, we speak power. When we speak that name of Jesus, we speak salvation. When we speak the name of Jesus, we speak his sinlessness. When we speak the name of Jesus, we speak his precious blood that he shed for us. When we speak the name of Jesus, we speak resurrection power. When we speak the name of Jesus, we speak of a coming king. When we speak the name of Jesus, we speak the name of our Savior and our Lord. And at his name, the enemy trembles. At his name, miracles happen. At his name, lost souls are saved. At his name, death has no victory. At his name, death is turned into life. At his name, God hears our prayers. His name is Jesus. He is the Lord. Amen. Don't wait to bow before him and confess him when it's too late. I encourage you today, acknowledge his sovereignty now. He is Lord. Do as Psalms 95:6 tells us to do. Oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker. But oh, my friends, be careful that you are not just calling him Lord. Make sure that you have made him Lord of your life. Accept his free gift of salvation, and he'll be both your Savior and your Lord. But I want you to hear this morning. Though he is Lord, he is gentle. He is gentle. Isaiah 9:6 reminds us of this, and the final name of Jesus we're going to look at this Christmas season, for he is Jesus, the Son of God. Jesus, the Son of God. Look at Isaiah 9:6, probably one of the most read verses at this time of year at Christmas. Isaiah 9:6 says, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Now we just looked at Jesus as Lord, and oh, he is Lord. But I don't want you to have the wrong idea this morning about his lordship and what kind of Lord he is. Because I believe there are people out there who think that Jesus as Lord is looking down on people and trying to take all the fun out of their lives. I truly think that's how some people see Christianity, and that is so far from the truth. That's not the kind of Lord Jesus is. I mean, just think about it. When a Lord that wants to take all your joy away, when you give up the glory of heaven, when he come to earth and experience the emotions that you and I feel, when he give up heaven to come feel sadness and hurt and pain and to be hungry and to be tired, exhausted, to be tempted by Satan himself. Would he do that? If he wanted to just rule over you and take your joy away. Then the one who is the name above every name, though he is Lord, he allowed mortal men to whip him, to spit on him, to mock him and mock his lordship with a crown of thorns, to drive nails into his hands and his feet and a cross and kill him upon the cross. That's the Lord we're talking about. That is Jesus the Lord. Would that kind of Lord do that so that he can rule over you and take away your joy? Absolutely not. But Jesus is Lord because he loves you so much. Does that sound like someone who wants to rule over you and take away your happiness? No. As God's Son who was given to us, this verse of Isaiah tells us what Jesus does for us and why he came. He came to be our wonderful counselor. And he's the first one I want to talk to when I'm upset. But you, I can go to Jesus and he'll lift my head. When I'm worried, I can go to him and his word said he'll guard my heart. When I'm scared, he's my rock. When I'm alone, he's the one who will never leave me and never forsake me. When I don't know what to do, he leads me on the path of righteousness. Whatever it is I may be going through, I can go to Jesus, the wonderful counselor. And I know that I can trust him. I know that I can trust his word and his power because he is also, as we read, the mighty God. He is the word that was with God. He's the word that was God. And he's the word that came and dwelt among us. Mighty God came and lived like you and I live. And because of that, he understands. As I wrote that in my notes yesterday, God pressed that into my heart and made me feel like there's somebody here that needs to hear that today. Somebody needs to hear that, that God understands, because today you are hurting. You're hurting. And so I want to just pause right here for a moment. Would you just place in your mind whatever it is that might be troubling you today, if I'm speaking to you right now? And would you proclaim this over it? Jesus understands. Is it you that God's speaking to right now? Is it you that needs to hear that today? Jesus understands. He understands what you're going through. And yes, he's the Son of God, but he's the everlasting Father. Remember that Emmanuel means God with us. And that 1 John teaches us that Jesus was both with God and he was God. So just as God is everlasting, so is Jesus. He's the Son of God. That means that he will never change. Jesus will always be Savior. Jesus will always be Lord. Jesus will always be. Now how do I know that Jesus understands what's troubling you today? How do I know that? It's because God's word tells us. Hebrews 4:15 tells us this about Jesus. We do not have a high priest who's unable to empathize with our weaknesses, but we have one who's been tempted in every way just as we are, yet he did not sin. So whatever you're feeling today, if you're dreading Christmas, hey, maybe you maybe have to spend tomorrow alone. I know some people who are. You may be dreading tomorrow. He understands. He's the mighty God. He's the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords. He's the Son of God. But he understands what you are feeling. And let's close with this final name of Jesus. He's the Prince of Peace. And knowing that he understands me, knowing that he knows what I go through and what I feel, that brings me a lot of peace. He's the everlasting Prince of Peace. You can't just forget about him. He's not going anywhere. He's not going to just go away. He's eternal. He's the everlasting Father and the Prince of Peace. You may have seen the bumper sticker that says, Without Jesus, there is no peace. N-O peace, but with Jesus, you can know peace. K-N-O-W, peace. He's the Prince of Peace. It's so true. And you know, peace is often a word that we see in this season. But do you really have peace? And not just any peace, but the peace of God that surpasses all understanding. You can have it if you have Jesus in your heart. You can have that Prince of Peace dwelling in you, for He is the Prince of Peace. Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright. Round and virgin, mother and child, holy infant, so tender and mild. You know the next few words, don't you? Sleep in heavenly peace. Sleep in heavenly peace. Listen, on this Christmas Eve day, if you would just believe in Jesus, the Savior, Jesus, the Lord, Jesus, the Son of God, then tonight when you lay down, you too can sleep in heavenly peace. Because you'll have the Prince of Peace abiding in your heart. Would you choose Him today? Remember one day, we read it a moment ago, one day every knee is going to bow. And one day every tongue is going to confess that He's Savior, that He's Lord, He's the Son of God. And there'll be no doubt about it. Don't wait until that day. Don't wait until it's too late for you to declare it on your own and believe it on your own. Let Jesus be the Lord of your life today. And receive that precious gift God's word calls that indescribable gift of salvation that is only available through Jesus Christ. It's not through church membership. It's not because your parents were good Christians. It's not because you teach Sunday school. It's not because you're baptized. It's not because any of those things. The only way that you could be saved today, God's word says, if you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus is what? That He's Lord. You shall be saved. Who needs to do that today? If God's speaking to your heart, you know it. You know it's you. You know you need to choose Jesus today. The only question is, will you? It's a free gift. Jesus paid it all to Him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain. But if you choose Him, He'll wash it white as snow. Amen. Choose Jesus today. Be saved. Heads bowed and eyes closed for just a moment, please. We have lots of visitors today, and I don't know everybody's heart. I don't know your spiritual condition today, and I wouldn't dare venture to guess. That's between you and the Lord. But I do know this. I don't want anybody to leave the sanctuary this morning without knowing that Jesus is Lord of their life and knowing that they can have that sweet Prince of Peace as they lay their head down on their pillow tonight, living in their hearts. And so I want to give you an opportunity now, right where you are, to pray a simple prayer, acknowledging that Jesus is what we've said He is today, that He's came to be your Savior, that He's the Lord, He's the Son of God. So if you'd like to acknowledge that today and receive His gift of salvation, I want you to pray right where you are. You don't have to pray out loud. You can just pray in your heart. The most important thing you can do is make sure that your heart means what you pray. It's more important than the words you say. It's the condition of your heart today. Is your heart willing to receive Jesus this morning? And if it is, would you pray with me? Dear Heavenly Father, I believe that Jesus is your Son. I believe that He came to be my Savior. I believe that He died on the old rugged cross and shed His blood to pay the price for my sins. And I acknowledge that I am a sinner. Please forgive me. I believe in my heart, and Lord, I confess with my mouth right now that your Son Jesus is Lord. Please save me now. I'll live my life for you. All heads bowed, all eyes closed. This morning, if you pray that prayer for the very first time, never in your life before, you've never asked Jesus to save you before, but you prayed it for the first time this morning, would you just lift your hand up with nobody looking around and all heads bowed? If you did that this morning, would you just lift your hand right where you are? Amen. Amen. There are some in this place who prayed that prayer this morning. Praise the Lord for that. Amen. Praise the Lord for that. I'm so thankful for you. And I want you to know, God's word is true, and it says if you believe it and you confess it, then you are saved. So don't let Satan tell you any differently this morning. You saved. God saved you this morning. Now we're going to have this time of invitation. I want to be here at the front. And I invite you, if you would, and you ask Jesus to save you today, would you just come up here and let me pray with you, and you can let the church know today that you are saved. Or maybe somebody didn't pray a moment ago, but you wish you did, and you would come up here and have me pray with you now. That's fine, too. This is the day of salvation. God is good. And you can have that salvation today if you need it. So you just come as you need to. Father, we thank you for those souls that you saved this morning. I thank you for their hands raised to confess that they believe. We are so thankful, Lord, for them. I pray you give them the boldness to let the church know today, or the family know. Father, I pray that if there be anybody else in here that needs to be saved, that they would make that choice now during this time of invitation. We give this time to you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Let's all stand this morning. If you feel like you need to come, I invite you to come. Thank you. always be open and move as the Spirit moves. And it's good to see people at the altar praying for one another and bringing their burdens before the Lord. It's been a good service this morning. And I'm so thankful that you're here, a guest, and Amber is thankful that you chose to be with us. We hope you felt right at home. We want to invite you to come back and be with us again next week. End out 2023 with another worship service. And no better way than I can think of to end the year in church worshiping the Lord. And so come back and join us again next Sunday morning. So the music's always good. The preaching couldn't get any better. Sorry. But I appreciate you. Appreciate you coming and being here. I'm not going to spend a long time on announcements. I know probably you have busy days today. But we don't have any activities tonight or this Wednesday. This is Family Focus Week, so spend this week, if you've got days off, spend this time with your family and just enjoy being together with them. No activities at church this Wednesday. Next Sunday morning will be a regular Sunday morning. We'll have Sunday school at 10 o'clock and worship service at 11, and then we won't have anything next Sunday evening. But looking forward to getting back again together next Sunday evening. Enjoy time with your family this week. And as you are spending time with your family tomorrow, I pray that you and your family have the merriest of Christmases. We want to acknowledge a couple here today. I found out this past week that we have a couple in our church who's been married 40 years yesterday, and that's Punk and Mickey Short. I don't know who put up with who the longest, but we're glad you did. That's right. So thank you, too, for being an example to the rest of us. To show us what true love means and how you stick together through thick and thin. Amen. But that's right. So you're an example to us, and we admire you those 40 years you spent with your wife there. So anybody else have something on your heart this morning, something you need to say, or Spirit's got something in your heart right now you need to say? Anybody?
I mean,
who
else
are going to
remember it's Jesus' birthday we're celebrating?
How
what you get, what you give.
That's right. So let's give him worship and praise, right? That's good. Thank you, Emma. Anybody else? Yes, ma'am. Oh, thank you. Appreciate it. That's sweet. Thankful for you, too. And Baseman Hardy back there. All right, if nothing else, then God bless you. Have a great day today and a great Christmas tomorrow. I love each and every one of you. And it's just, I can't even describe how much I love you, church. You are so awesome. And you're so special to Angela and I. My wife will be here, of course, today. She's taking care of her mom this week as her brother and sister-in-law are going to Costa Rica to be with his wife's family for this Christmas. So, but you pray for Angela. She takes care of her mom all this week. So I know it's a difficult time, but she does a great job, and we love her mom dearly. So, yes. Yes, thank you. Thank you. Christmas cards galore right out this door. So, if you want to come check and see if you've got Christmas cards over here, everybody in Jesus has cards over here. So come get your Christmas cards, put them under your tree, or open them at lunch, whatever you want to do, and enjoy getting those cards from your church family. And check that out before you leave. And don't forget, the offering plates are in the back. We can still give to Lottie Moon. And so if you haven't given to Lottie Moon yet, the International Missions, those envelopes are back there in the offering plate as well. It's not too late to do that if you'd like to do that today. All right, well, God bless you. Merry Christmas. And Anthony, would you care to dismiss us in prayer, brother?
Thank the Lord for all that you've done for us, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be in your house this morning, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for all the ones that made it out. And we just thank you, Lord, for what you've done for us. You came to this earth as a lowly child, Lord, but you died for our sins, Lord, on a lonely cross, Lord. We just ask you, Lord, to be with us and let us always understand what this season means, Lord. It is fun to get all the gifts, but it is better to give and receive, but we need to remember what you've done for us, Lord. We know that there's people that's in this world that's going to be sad and down through the holidays. We just ask you, Lord, that if we run across those, that we just be a light to them and let us show them your love through us, Lord. We just thank you, Lord, for everyone that's here and thank you, Lord, for this time. We just ask you, Lord, to let us go out into this world and be a light into this world, this dark world, Lord. Watch over us, keep us safe. Bring us back the next point of time. We ask in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Merry Christmas, Lord.